Welcome back to Spellup Tutorial Services. Today we're going to talk about direct variation. And a direct variation is when you have an equation in the form of y equals kx, where k is what's known as the constant of variation. All right, another important thing to note about the direct variation is that when you graph a direct variation is going to always cross or go through the origin here at 0, 0. So sometimes on an exam, you may get a picture of a graph and it'll ask you, is this a graph of a direct variation? If it goes through the center point here called the origin, then you'll know that that is a picture, or that graph does depict a direct variation. So here we'll begin with this example. The distance required to stop a car varies directly as the square of its speed. So if 200 feet are required to stop a car traveling 60 miles per hour, how many feet are required to stop a car traveling 100 miles per hour? In these types of problems, you really have to do it in two separate parts. So here we're talking about distance, and the distance I'm going to use y, and they're also talking about the square of the speed, and that there I'm going to depict as x to the second or x squared. So here we're going to do basically a substitution. If 200 feet, well, the feet is the distance, so that'll put in place where y is. K, or the constant variation, is what we need to find. And here we know that the speed is going to be x squared. So in this case, the speed is 60, and we need to square 60. So we begin by, again, always falling back to the order of operations. So we do our exponents first. 60 squared is actually 3,600. Now we go ahead and divide. We go ahead and divide both sides by 3,600. All right, in doing so, we now see these cancel, and we have to simplify k. We start off with 200 over 3,600. Well, these zeros go away just by dividing by 100. And then we end up with 2 over 36, which can be simplified down to 1/18. So we found our constant of variation, but we still haven't answered their question. Their question is, how many feet are required to stop a car traveling at 100 miles per hour? All right, now we don't know y, which is the distance. We have our constant of variation, which is 1/18, and we have the speed again, which is 100 miles per hour. So now we're going to do 100 squared. So 18 times 100 squared. Well, 100 times 100, again, we just write the 1, and we know we need 4 zeros. And then we just begin to solve. We have 10,000 divided by 18. Well, we can divide everything by 2. Half of 10,000 is 5,000. And then 18 divided by 2 is 9. 555 and 6/10. And that there tells us how many feet are required to stop that vehicle, which is traveling at 100 miles per hour. All right, that sums it up for this video from Spellup Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the same name. Thanks for watching.